My name is Bob Magnussen. I'm an orthopedic surgeon at OSU Sports Medicine. I specialize in the treatment of all athletic injuries, but primarily those involving the shoulder and the knee. Patellofemoral pain and patellofemoral instability are both common conditions involving the knee. Patellofemoral pain refers to pain in the front of the knee joint. It occurs most commonly with steps and with squatting. It can be quite debilitating to patients. Patellofemoral instability, on the other hand, refers to dislocation of the kneecap. This happens when the kneecap moves out to the outside of the knee. There are a number of causes of patellofemoral instability, the most common of which is direct trauma to the knee. So if you're playing a sport and there's an impact on the inside of the kneecap, knocking it out of position. Instability can also happen without trauma in cases where there are anatomic abnormalities of the knee. Maybe the kneecap is a little bit high or the groove that the kneecap sits in is a little bit flat that predispose to dislocation without an injury. Patellofemoral instability is treated a number of ways depending on how many times the kneecap is dislocated. The first time a kneecap dislocates, we generally treat that without surgery, with rehabilitation. However, sometimes when the kneecap dislocates, there can be an injury to the cartilage that would require surgery. It's important to see a physician and have the knee evaluated to determine if this is the case. If the kneecap dislocates multiple times, we often recommend a surgery to stabilize the kneecap and prevent further dislocations. After a patellar dislocation, athletes are very commonly able to return to sport. If it's a first-time dislocation that we're treating with rehabilitation, the time to return to sport ranges from several weeks up to several months, depending on how long it takes to regain stability and strength in the leg. If surgery is required, athletes typically return to sport within 4 to 6 months, depending on what needs to be done. Patellofemoral pain is quite different from patellofemoral instability in that the vast majority of patients never require surgery. There's been a lot of research recently looking into treatment for patellofemoral pain. Currently, we focus on physical therapy, focusing on strengthening the quadriceps as well as the hip musculature and core. Recent evidence has shown that this really helps a lot of patients get rid of their pain and return to activities. Here at OSU Sports Medicine, we have a great interest in the patellofemoral joint and have a lot of ongoing research projects to improve our care of these patients. We have a strong multidisciplinary team consisting of physicians, physical therapists, and other providers to help return these athletes to their sport as quickly as possible.